Hello, welcome students to my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to discuss the concept of federalism. So this is chapter 2, federalism, social science, and it is political science chapter 2. Okay, and please like and subscribe my YouTube channel for new updates. So get ready. And first of all, we will discuss the concept of federalism. So what is the concept of federalism? So the real thing is that federalism is a system of government in which the power is divided between the central authority and the various constituent units of the country. Okay, so federalism kya ek sanghya vyavastha hai, ek sangh ke andar ek jo ek central government hota hai, central authority and uska jo constituent unit hote hai, aap desh ke sab ek sath kaam karna. Okay, then the federal has two level of government. A federation has two levels of government. So what is the first one? And what is the government for the entire country? And that is usually responsible for a few subject of common national interest. Okay, ek desh bhar ka jo government hota hai, jo central government hota hai, that is the first one, first form of the federation. And second form is the other are governments at the level of province, and province means here the states that look after much of the day-to-day administering of their state. एक हो गया सेंट्रल लेवल पे जो गवर्नमेंट रहता है, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. एंड देन सेकंड पॉइंट हो गया, द सेकंड टाइप होता है दैट इज द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. ओके, सो दीज आर द टू लेवल्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द फेडरेशन. देन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज बोथ दिस लेवल्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स एंजॉय देयर पावर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ ईच अदर. एंड इन दिस सेंस फेडरेशन आर कॉन्ट्रास्टेड विथ यूनिटरी गवर्नमेंट्स. But under the unitary system, either there is only one level of government or the sub units are subordinate to the central government. This thing is very important here. Both and aapko ek point ye hum yaad karna hai that the both these levels of government enjoy their power independently of each other. Then next point is the central government can pass on orders to the provincial or the local governments. And in a federal system, the central government cannot order state government to do something, but it can pass on orders to the local government, but it cannot order the state government. This is the difference. The state government has powers of its own for which it is not answerable to the central government. Yeah, this is very important that the state government has powers of its own and for which it is not answerable to the central government. But both government are separately answerable to the people. They are not free. So it be the central government or it be the state government, they are separately answerable to the people for their omission and commission of activity, all act of omission and commission. Okay, so thank you students for watching the video. Please like and subscribe my YouTube channel.